Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a blush collection video. This is another episode in my collection series where I take you through a different category of my makeup collection and show you every product that I have in that category of makeup. So today is blush. I'll be showing you all of my like single blushes that aren't in like a duo or a blush palette. I already have a blush palette collection up on my channel which has all of my blushes that are in like palettes or duos or combos like that. But today I'll be showing you all of my single blushes and yeah, I'll be getting straight into it. First of all, I wanted to start off by showing you my Milani Luminoso blush. This is a cult favourite and it's really popular on YouTube. I won't be swatching any of these because I feel like blushes aren't that good for swatching anyway, but it's like just not practical for me. So yeah, this is the Luminoso blush. I really dig into this when I use it. It has the slightest amount of sheen to it, but nothing too much, nothing like garish or anything. And I really love the peachy coral shade this is. If I was to go for a blush, this is the kind of tone I would go for. I'm obsessed with like peachy coral shades and this is right up my alley. So yeah, the Milani Luminoso blush is definitely one of my favorites. It was a new addition to my collection last year and I've been absolutely loving it so far. The next blush I have here to show you is a huge version of the NARS Orgasm blush. I previously had a mini like a duo size of this and I really loved it. I used up the whole thing. I really love the shade of NARS Orgasm. This is like a giant one, so it came with like hashtag what makes you blush on the like mirror it says there. And then it came with like this cute overlay that I keep over it because it's like this cute like NARS Orgasm lady. Anyway, the shade inside is the famous Orgasm flavor. Orgasm color shade, and yeah, it's just like the classic peachy corally blush that I'm obsessed with. Yeah, it's just my favorite shade of blush, and usually when I search for other blushes, this is the kind of tone I go for just because it's a favorite to me. It's just like natural glowing from within vibes and it's so cute and gives just the perfect right amount of sheen. It kind of has like a gold like reflect through it, but nothing like highlight vibes. It's just like a little bit of a natural glow. So yeah, really love the NARS Orgasm blush. The next blush I want to talk about is the Too Faced Love Flush blush. Oh my goodness. In the shade So Happy Together. This is kind of like a cooler tone blush for me. I don't know. It just has a little bit of like a purpley cooler reflect through it. But it still is definitely something I can pull off. I was a little hesitant to start wearing this just because I was worried that it was going to look like weird or like icy on the skin, but it really is like pull offable. I think it's really cute and yeah, I have the teeniest amount of baby pan. You won't be able to see it on camera, but I'll probably use this up this year because it's so little. It's just a little sample size. I kind of wish Too Faced didn't like discontinue their heart Too Faced blushes just because they were so cute. I didn't pick up any of those, but I just happened to get this one as a little sample. I think it was in like a Mecca beauty loop box or something, but yeah, really cute little Too Faced Love Flush blush. Next I'll show you some Benefit tints. So I have Benny Tint, which is like a rosy red kind of shade. These can be used as cheek products, like as a loose cheek tint, or you can use them as a lip tint. I usually use them as a cheek tint, but you could use them for the lips as well. There's also Posy Tint, which is probably my favorite out of the ones I have. This one's more of like a pinky shade. I've just opened the applicator so you can see. It's just like a pinkier shade, more along the like coral lines that I'm into. With that peachy shade. And then this is Lolly Tint. This one is like a little bit out of my comfort zone, but it's definitely wearable and it's nothing too like crazy for me. So thank goodness, because I don't know, I wouldn't go for like a crazy blush shade and I was worried this would be too crazy for me, but it's really not. It's definitely natural on the skin. I just like, I feel like it goes really well with like some of the cool tone makeup looks I do and stuff. But even like with a warm tone or natural everyday look like I wear every day like this, it still looks really cute. So love Lolly Tint. I'll show you two blushes that I haven't dug into. The first one is the Kylie Cosmetics Kylie blush in the shade Pink Dreams, and it just looks like this. I haven't popped into these two because they have really nice like pressed designs on them and I haven't got the heart to like dig into them yet. I will dig into them eventually. I'm just like waiting a little bit for, oops, I almost dropped this. Oh my goodness. If I dropped this blush and it broke, I would be so shattered. I would be shattered like the blush. Anyway, but yeah, I haven't dug into this yet because I'm just using up some other blushes until I start on this one, but I will definitely be using this eventually. I just am admiring it for now. It's so cute. I feel like this is going to be such a sweet, like, pastel pink blush for the winter time. It's like a little winter kiss. It is the combination of two of Kylie's blushes. It's Winter Kiss and Pink Dreams, I believe. No, wait, this is Pink Dreams. I can't remember. I think it's Baddie on the Block and Winter Kiss. They combine those together to get Pink Dreams. And this is Pink Dreams. So it's like the combination of their two most best-selling shades. It's a really pretty blush. And yeah, can't wait to try it out. You can like see my room. That's why I like cover the mirrors. Anyway, this is the other one I was mentioning. And this is the California blush from Benefit. It just looks like this on the inside. It has this brush that no one uses. And it just has the most beautiful golden sun design on the inside. And it's just beautiful. So I'll probably have like a couple of uses out of this, like out of the gold, where I'll apply the blush and it looks really golden on the face. But yeah, it's just another one of those blushes that I typically go for, like that peachy, corally kind of shade. I'm hoping this is quite pigmented because I want a like really flush look with this. But yeah, the design on the front's really cute too. She's like a gal in California. She's a California gal. But yeah, I really like this blush. And apparently it has a scent and I didn't know. And then when I purchased it, it does have a scent. It's like, it reminds me of a peach Bellini. I love peach Bellinis, so yum. Really like this blush. I hope it has that scent when I'm applying on my face. That'd be really cute. Next, I'm going to show you some blushes from MAC. I purchased these all at like Boxing Day. I bought the shade Desert Rose, which is kind of like a dusty mauvey rose shade, as you can tell. Love this. I've worn all of these and I really like the MAC blush formula. I've got two different kinds of formulas. Some of these are powder blushes. Yeah, I got Desert Rose and Melba in powder blush, and the other two are a different formula. I'll tell you when we get there. But this is Melba. This is so classic. This is the one that I felt like everybody had on YouTube back in the day. It's kind of like a corallier neutral blush. Like, it's definitely a neutral blush still. It's not like bright the way that like California or like Orgasm are, but it's erring on that like orangier side than rather on the pink side. The other two MAC blushes I have are sheer tone blushes. That's what they're called. Anyway, I have Gingerly, which is really nice and kind of like a gingery brownie shade. Like, the shade names like really describe it well. So yeah, that's Gingerly. And then the other one I have is Pinch Me. I'm wearing Pinch Me today. I'm also really hot right now because it's really hot in Australia. So that's my like natural blush too. But Pinch Me is like, it's kind of like a rosy mauvey shade again, but it's different to Desert Rose. I'll show you them in comparison. Like, Desert Rose is a little bit more cool toned, whereas Pinch Me is a little bit like peachier. I don't know. I also have one more blush that's over there, so I'll just go and grab it. This is the last blush I wanted to share with you guys today, the last one in my collection that I have. It's the Fenty Beauty blush in the shade, it's a Kilowatt Foil. That's what the formula is called. Freestyle Highlighter, but I use it as a blush. It's in the shade Ruby Riches, and it's this really rich, kind of like, I don't know how to describe it. It's like a pinky, mauvey, it's got reflex through it, it's got a bit of a sheen, but it just looks like a flush from deep within. Like, if you went and ran a marathon on a 40 degree day and you were so hot and running in the heat, this is the color of blush you would get. It's like a really like hearty, earthy blush, if that makes sense. I don't know, that's the vibes I get from it. It's from like a hot day. This is the blush you get on a hot day. It's a really deep sunburnt kind of flush, and I really love the way this looks on the cheeks. I use this as an eyeshadow as well, and I think that looks really cute. And yeah, just really love the Fenty Kilowatt Foil formula. So yeah, absolutely love this blush and a great addition to my collection. Guys, I stopped filming and I forgot to show you my actual last blush. This is the Benefit Fine 1-1. I'm not sure if they still make this, but I bought this when I was in high school and I still love it. There's not that much product left though. It's a sheer brightening color for lips and cheeks. And it also has an illuminator in there, but I only use this on cheeks. I never use this as a lip color. That's all I have left. It's kind of sad. I should just finish it up instead of like being sad about it. But it's a really gorgeous product. This melts into the skin so beautifully. It has like three colors in there. If you can see, it's got like a champagne-y kind of highlight shade. That's really gorgeous. It melts into the skin. Just looks like a sheen. It's beautiful. There's this like pinky tone, which kind of looks like a sunburn from like, it's like a sunny glow from within kind of vibe. And then it has that corally shade underneath. And the way they've paired that is really cute because you've got the highlight on the top and the orangey shade kind of blends it into where you will have the bronzer next. So yeah, just absolutely love this blush so much. One of my favorites, and I couldn't leave it out of this video. I couldn't forget it because I love this so much and I'll be very sad when I use it up because it's so cute. It looks so nice on the face. It's just like a dewy little like fresh blush. It's so cute. I've been trying to branch out recently because I used to not be a blush person and like never wear blush, but recently I've been really loving like a flush look, and I've been trying to expand away from just like the Orgasm shade because I would just wear shades like Orgasm and like peachy corally with little gold reflex and I would never expand. So recently I've been expanding my blush collection and I've been having lots of fun doing so. So yeah, if you liked my If you liked my collection, please give this video a thumbs up. Comment anything you'd like to see from me in future down below, something you'd like to see next from my collection or something else like that. Subscribe if you would like to see more content from me, and hopefully I'll see you in a future video soon. Thank you so much for watching. Bye!